No Limit. We back, man. We back. We back on the, you know, MTB, MB, murdered, you know, music to be murdered by, man. The saga. So it continues, man. And I think, you know, from what I've heard thus far, I'm pretty sure I heard every song on his album. I just can't remember. I played the hell out of it, man, when it first dropped. So, but from what I remember, man, this song here is my favorite thus far. I know there's a couple I haven't listened to, so I was kind of trying to save them, you know. I knew I was going to be doing this, so. But yeah, man, this one here is dope. I haven't heard it in a minute, so we're going to be refreshing up on it, man. And yeah. Try and catch as much as we can, but let's get into it, y'all. Y'all ready? Yeah, man. Let's go. Let's get into it, man. My bad. I was going to tell y'all something else, but we'll hold off on that for a minute. Anyway, you going to learn, man. Featuring Royce da 5'9" and White Gold. Let's get it. I don't know what it is, bro. I love that. The cadence, the size, how it's like slowed down. Just every, it's dope, man. It's dope. I don't know, I rock with it. You ain't saw your last rock, you just better earn. Better pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. You ain't saw your last rock, you just better earn. Little boy, you gon' learn. I'm a product of properly hopping up out of that poverty, profiting off of copping and swapping that property out for a possible monopoly. Jesus, man, you ever hear something just so dope in it? I can't help but imagine it myself right now, you know? It just like takes the breath out of you, bro. Just I don't know, man. Just the peas, man. The peas. The product, the property, right? They ain't get me started, bro. I'm a product of properly hopping up out of that poverty, profiting off of copping and swapping that. I'm a product of hopping out of that poverty. Oh, bro, we'd be here all day. I'm a product of properly hopping up out of that poverty. I'm a product of properly hopping up out of that property. Jesus, bro. I'm a product of poverty, popping top of the property. Copping and swapping that property out for a possible monopoly. Trying not to adopt my father's old philosophies. Same time, I'm praying to God that everything works out at his colonoscopy. Trying not to adopt his whole philosophy. But at the same time, praying everything works out at his colonoscopy. Ooh, that shit goes hard, bro. Yo, Royce 5'9", man. He's one of the GOATs too, man, and this shit, he's one of the few people, I think, in the, you know, on this earth that could hang in right in there with them, man, you know? I'm not saying he could, you know, he's damn close. He's damn near close, bro. I'm a product of properly hopping up out of that poverty, profiting off of copping and swapping that property out for a possible monopoly. Trying not to adopt my father's old philosophies. Same time praying to God that everything works out as colonoscopy. I'm walking across a suicidal tightrope intentionally. While the demons coming out of me, wifey's on the side of me talking sense into me. Walking on a suicidal tightrope. While the demons coming out of me, wifey's on the side of me talking. Bro. I'm gonna keep running this back, y'all, cause I'm going through it, man. I'm picking it out. You know what I mean? I'm not just gonna flush right through it real quick, bro. I'm praying to God that everything works out at his colonoscopy. I'm walking across a suicidal tightrope intentionally. While the demons coming out of me, wifey's on the side of me talking sense into me. Without she, I feel incomplete mentally. She's been sent to me right there since 9-6. Worst nightmare to side chicks. Some things are just meant to be. Worst nightmare to side chicks, man. That ride or die, that wifey, man. That, you know, the, one that's gonna be through it all, man. That's dope. Heaven sent to me. That's what he said. This is it for me. Give my daughters a kiss for me. Y'all call this fame, I call this, oh, this shit alcoholistic infamy. Alcoholistic infamy. I don't know why I struggle with that. It ain't, bro. Here's one thing, man. You wouldn't think. As long as I've been doing these videos already, man, I still. And I'm not the type of person, man. You ever meet me in person, I'm chill, laid back. Just about nothing gets me nervous, bro. Not a job interview. Nothing. Not anymore. I used to, you know. But this one thing, bro. Doing videos is still. It's not that it makes me nervous. It's just you got to be on your A game, and you don't want to. You know what I mean? I don't want to. I don't know. I guess that's why. Like I be forgetting shit. You know, whenever I forget someone here, I would never forget it otherwise or anywhere else. I'd be able to tell you anything, any. So that's another thing, man. Once I really break through this, which I already have a lot, right? I'm a lot more comfortable than I once was, but when I fully do, bro, I know, you know, y'all really gonna see, you know, what a lot of other people see. And I just feel like, I don't know, man. I don't think it's a like, I like to treat this, you know, No Limit, just this channel. This is not my channel. It's our channel. I'm still doing your guys' requests. And to me, it's more like a family thing, man. Y'all are my extended family. And I mean that when I'm not saying it, bro. I wouldn't say it if I, trust me, I would not say it if I didn't mean it. Because there's no fake in me, bro. There is no, so I wouldn't just say shit to say it, bro. That's just not something I do. And, I just feel like it's not a saying of when, you know, when is this channel going to take off? Because it will. It's just a when, basically. And I know when is. When is when I find, you know, my interior audience, man. My audience that relates to me. The audience that thinks more like me, you know. And, yeah, man, I mean, I feel like one of the reasons I relate to him a lot, too, is because, I mean, I think other than the podcast, the first time I've ever said it out loud, bro, I mean, I'm a recovering addict myself, man. I've spent, 2.5 years of opioids, you know, never used any, like, you know, not actual hard, you know, but well, I'm not going to say I haven't, you know, but that's not what I was, you know, primarily. Just pills, man, opiates. Y'all know the epidemic, man, before this pandemic. So, and I'm proud, man. It's like, it's not something I'm ashamed of, necessarily. It's just something that I didn't want certain people to know before I got the chance to tell them, you know what I mean? Not, like, when the time was right, not just, you know, forcing it because y'all know. But anyway, yeah, man, I'm proud to say that's not, you should never be ashamed of something that you know, whatever, how it happened, you know, didn't really have any control of the circumstances, because it's what made who you are today. So, you know, I'm not ashamed, bro. I'm not ashamed to say. I'm actually more proud to say, you know, that I'm doing good, man. Doing the best shit I ever been. So, yeah, man. What's there to be ashamed of? Shit, you know. But anyway, I hope y'all can relate. Targeting my kids and babies through population and gun control. Shit make me wanna make 100 more. Make a bigot racist uncomfortable. Oh shit! One more thing. That's what I really want to start pushing. It's like, two is I've been there, man. So I know exactly. I know the feeling, and I know struggling to get, you know, to get free from that grip. It's like it's got a grip around you and it just won't let go. And you get to that point where it's like you almost, you don't want to fight the good fight anymore. And I'm here to tell you, man, that's never, even though you may have those thoughts, that's never the route, bro, because there's always an easier way out. And I tell you, I promise you, no matter how bad it is or how bad you think it's going to be, it's going to be rough. It's going to be hard. But Like, there's always going to be a light at the end of the tunnel, man. I always thought it was bullshit, you know, it was BS, but until I went through it myself, you know, and I've been through more shit than just that. I've been through a ton of shit, bro. That's like shit that I shouldn't even be here anymore, bro. I should not be on this earth. I should not be in the positive mind state that I am. Let's say that. But yeah, man, it's like, never take that route. Because you even if you're the lowest point you've ever been, you didn't even think it's possible to get this low. Look what, dude, a year later, 2 years later. I mean, you could be on top of the world where you never imagined you could be. It, shit changes, man, and you can turn it all around. It's just up to you, man. You gotta get the help you need, man. You need professional help. You cannot do this on your. It's not something you can do on your own. So, I'm sorry, y'all. I went on a little rant there, but yeah, I had to get that out, man. Y'all call this fame. I call this shit alcoholistic infamy. Cause I saw it just reminded me. Cause Race 5'9" talked about his father had, you know, alcohol. That's why he said alcoholistic infamy, because he felt like it had it in for him, like it's genetic. And that's what he meant when he said he didn't want to, you know, take on his whole father's, you know, whatever he said. Because, yeah, he prayed everything went good at his colonoscopy, but he didn't want to take on, you know, everything. And I think he was talking from that aspect, because he said that, you know, I think he was a cocaine addict too. So, yeah, he just didn't want to. That's basically what he's talking about. It just reminded me of it, because not that neither of those are the problem I had, but it's all the same in a similar way, man. It's addiction, bro. So, yeah, you can overcome it. That's all I'm here to say, man. Targeting my kids and babies through population and gun control. Shit make me want to make 100 more. Make a bigot racist uncomfortable. If y'all against talking reparation, then I'm not against the thought of separation. Why the politicians and white and privilege act ties is different from segregation. That's funny, bro. Segregation is being told where I'm gonna go. Separation is being woke and going wherever I want to go. Hey, you see tomorrow, little boy, you gonna learn. Waste 5'9", his... He said a lot, man. He said a lot, and his verse was hard, bro. I don't know. His verse in this shit was just prolific to me, man. It stuck with me. You know, I'd hear it. The song would be in my head for weeks, and I would hear that. And it really got through to me. I don't know. Just makes you think, bro, and that's what we need. Like, even in a time like now, man, we can't forget. You know, the everything, the injustices, everything that's going on around us. We can't just get swooped up in politics, you know, the Rona. It's like there's still everything else that we got going on. We just gotta just be mindful. That's all I'm saying, bro. Pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gonna learn. All the pretty bitches leave your ass in the urn. You ain't saw your last rock, you just better earn. The prayer you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. You say pretty bitches leave your ass in the urn. Facts, that's facts. You know how many men lost their life over a female man? Like, how many dudes got smoked? Over some drama, over a female man, you know, like, it's not that, like, I'm not saying that they're not worth it, because everybody's human, bro, but I'm saying that there's too many women out there to be taking someone else's life or throwing your life away, you know, doing life in prison over, it's just too many. It's like, yeah, I know how passionate you feel about it now, but when you move on, man, and it, you know, it sucks, whatever, there'll be someone else, man. And, you know, in that time, you'll be like, man, I can't believe I was thinking about, you know, A and B. I can't believe I was thinking about going over there doing A to B. Like, don't, it ain't worth it, bro. Move on with your life. You got better shit to do anyway, right? You got a future, just move on, man. Trust me. Goddamn. Never so dope, full of gold rope. Wanted one though, they were so dope. Was a half knot, but a hack is didn't have knots. I was so broke. Oh, bro, this shit's so hard. I love this song. Never sold dope. Well, I actually did, so I can't say that, but if y'all want to know more about that, go over to the podcast. No Limit Podcast episode 2 out now. That's what I was talking about to y'all, man. When I was trying to get y'all to go over there and watch it, I really came out with everything, bro. I got everything off my chest. Y'all find out, man. Y'all see. And, you know, people might have a problem with it. If they do, they can, you know, they can leave. They don't have to stay. They don't have to watch. That's fine. But if you, you know, if you relate or you rock with it, whatever. It doesn't matter, man. I just had to get it out there. So you know a little bit about me, my past, my history. So that's the thing to me. If they don't accept that it's my past, bro, I can't change it. You know, that doesn't... That's also another reason I didn't want to put everything out, because it's like people just judge you. They judge you no matter what. So, and I don't really give a fuck, but I'm saying you can't judge me from that stuff in my past. And who I am today is who I am today. You know, I'm not that person anymore. So it's like that almost felt like a different lifetime. I know it wasn't that long ago, but shit, to me, it did, you know. Been through so much since then. I'm a totally different person, bro. So. Yeah, and always, I don't know, man, you can see it, you know, real see, real recognize real, that shit, that's not just a saying, bro, you can usually spot it from a mile away. So dope, yeah. Was a half not, cause my pockets didn't have knots, I was so broke. On my last ride, for my slingshot, better haul ass, don't be no slow poke, through the tall grass, run your ass off, yeah. Oh no, got your pants caught on the fence post, getting chased, got them jack boys, they can spot the fuzz like a lint roller, they wait till it's late, they will tiptoe through your... They can spot the fuzz like a lint roller. Yo, that was me too, bro, I swear. Well, see, when you're in that lifestyle, man, you're 24/7 looking in your rearview mirror, looking in your, you know what I mean? Your rearview, your side mirrors, you're always looking. But I could tell the police headlights from anybody else's headlights from down. I mean, to the point where you're just starting to see these headlights, I could spot it, just the shape of it. But that's when it used to be like all Crown Vicks and stuff, you know. Really before all this, undercover... Now they be in anything. You don't know what they're going to be driving, but... Yeah, it's just crazy, bro. I'm going to run this back, because he has some bars in there. From a gold rope. One and one, though. They were so dope. Didn't have knots, because my pockets, they were so broke. Didn't have knots. I know he said I was a have not, didn't have nots. Damn it, man, why is it? They were so dope. Was a have not, cause my pockets didn't have nots. I was so broke. Yeah, cause my pockets didn't have nots, I was so broke. On my last ride for my slingshot, better haul ass, don't be no slow poke. Through the tall grass, run your ass off. Oh no, got your pants caught on the fence post, getting chased. Got them jack boys, think it's about the fuzz like a lint roll. Let it wait till it's late, they will tiptoe through your living room window, ticket Nintendo and then skate. You feel like you got bent over and raped, little boy, you're never gonna get. That shit was hard, that. I know y'all heard that. They would creep through your window, take it in, no Nintendo, then skate. You're never gonna get no rope chain, get your shit stolen, your lips swole. I became bitter as I got a little bit older. Oh, it was making me get cold, began to get a chip shoulder, started to spit vogue on my zip code, have been skid roll, but I ate every single beast that I spit over the shithole I escaped. Then I began to explode, detonate. Now the east side went schizo. Thought my name was B-side, cause sex, they flipped over my tape. And I thought my name was B-side, cause they flipped over my tape. I don't know if y'all, I mean, shit, I barely remembered, you know. I had to figure this out. I was like, they used to have an A-side and a B-side of the tape, and when you flip it over, it'd be the B-side, but shit, there was already CDs, bro, when I was a kid, so, but I've seen tapes, you know, when my mom's had a bunch of them, you know. But shit, man, I was born in 91, so just on the edge of that, man, 90s baby. Shout out to all my 90s babies. Yeah. I'm just fucking around, y'all. I'm in a good mood, man. I'm being positive, you know what I mean? Trying to make the best out of, you know, you guess all you can do. Make the best of what you have. This year, everything else, you know, it's life, man. Life happens, but shit's been rough for me lately, man. And I know it has for everybody. I'm not just saying. I just mean particularly lately, like past few weeks. And we all go through it, bro, so it's all good. Yeah, you can find out more of that over on the podcast as well. I know this reaction is going to be like 30 minutes, and I apologize, y'all, but I'm glad. I mean, I'm just, I don't know. This shit is like, I don't know. This song, bro, this track, this whole album, fire to me. So this shit's more up my alley. So I get more, I don't know, I get excited, bro, when I'm reacting to this. You know, try and break down the bars. Hesitate to get them all bent so out of shape. Sit, both hold up, wait. I just tripped over my cape. Bro, the first time I heard that. This is what I'm saying. I wish I was a reaction channel when this album dropped, because the first time I heard that shit, I died laughing so hard. I thought, like, wait, I know this was, you know, I don't know. It wasn't recorded live, so they did this in post, and for a minute, you're like, what the hell? He fell during his, the way they did the voice, like, faded out. It sounded like he really fell, bro. That shit was hilarious. Hold up, wait. I tripped over my cape. Sound like he fell and got back up. I'm like, whoops. Hold up, wait. I just tripped over my cape. Stop. So when you refer to the guy next to the document shredder, the cops will set up roadblocks on my. When they tell you Dre, they tell you I shred. So when, that's a bar and a half right there. So when they refer you to the document shredder, like a, y'all know the document shredder, when you shreds up the piece of papers, but they're referring to the guy next to the document shredder. So Dr. Dre talking about Eminem standing next to Doc. When you're referring to Eminem, the guy next to the doc, you mean shredder, because he shreds any rapper that gets in his way. Woo, that shit was hard. Tell you I shred. So when you refer to the guy next to the document shredder, now the cops wanna set up roadblocks on my head. I got several bounties from feds in every county. I'm with a gal at a checkers wilding, bumping fuck the police at a federalis. Bumping fuck the police while I fed her rallies. But while the federalis are on his tail, and then, but he fed his girl rallies while I fed her rallies. Oh man. Em, you gotta stop, bro. You gotta stop. It's like rubber room. Why do I feel responsible for these kids? All of whom I'm a father to. I'm a god to you. Y'all better worship the water. I walk on it. Y'all gonna meet your Waterloo. I get the flipping. The mic is a murder weapon. I'm popping an extra clip and cut and shoot. Then I'm popping. Do not let me catch you slipping. I will pop up and I'll take a spot from you. I get to doing what a leaky faucet do. But I'm talking drip when I say the strap on you. Singing for all of you in auto tune. I'm too volatile and too grizzly to bear. God, bro. I know when I first started, I was like, eh, I ain't talking dripping when I get to dropping you. But it's, I ain't talking about a leaky faucet when I get to dripping. Damn it, I got it mixed up again. They're doing what a leaky faucet do when I ain't talking drip when I say I get to drop on you. But I ain't talking drip when I say I get to drop in you. Like, when I'll get the drop on you, like, catch you slipping. And also when drop, like, that's a double entendre in itself, man. He's saying, when I get the drop on you. So, I caught you slipping. I got the drop on you, you know, you're fucked. You can't do nothing. But also, but I ain't talking drip when I get the drop on you. Like, when he gets the drop on you to the ground. Because he caught you slipping. Bro, this. Maybe see tomorrow, little boy, you gonna learn. And I know y'all know, you know, you probably know who he was talking about there by now. It was your boy Nick Cannon. When I wish I would've. Bro, if I could have had, you know, my reaction channel, man, when this whole MGK and Eminem, that beef happened, and the little one with Nick Cannon and all that, that shit was fire, bro. Not to mention if a few of my favorite tracks came out on that, man, you know, which I still have yet to react to, man, from him. Yeah, And the one with Logic, Homicide. Oh, bro. Let me know if y'all want me to react to that, man. But you ain't sell your last rock, you just better earn. Better pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. Pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon' learn. All them pretty bitches leave your ass in the urn. You ain't sold your last rock, you just better earn. Better pray you see tomorrow, little boy, you gon'. Woo! That shit was hard, y'all. Hey, man. Appreciate y'all sticking around with me. Sorry for taking so long with this video, but I had to do it, man. I got some good shit up, you know. And, yeah, we broke it down the best we could. Let me know you guys enjoyed the video by leaving a like. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button on your way out, man. The notification bell, that way you get notified every time I drop a video. No Limit Podcast, man. Link in the description. Y'all go check that out. Other than that, I'm going to catch y'all on the next one, man. No Limit Gang, man. Oh, yeah, man. Stay safe. Stay out the way. I'm gone.